pleasure to be here today with you. I'm going to be talking about Bomba. My name is Pablo Shine. I'm artist, percussionist, and this is my wife, Amy Fenton Shine, an artist also and a percussionist, not only here, but she's a great percussionist with her feet. And a great photographer too. The painting that you see behind was inspired by one of her photographs. And that painting is called Majestad Negra, Black Majesty, and is dedicated to the great poet Luis Pales Matos, who devoted a great deal of his work to the Afro-Puerto Rican roots. So Bomba, where did it come from? It was originated on the sugarcane fields of Puerto Rico. African slaves came to the island as early as 1517 and worked on the sugarcane fields on and off until 1873. And then slavery was forbidden. It didn't stop there, but it was forbidden. They would work on the sugarcane fields long days, grueling days, and then at the end of the day, if they still have energy, they would play bomba music, sing, and dance. And that was, you know, how this happened. Fortunately for us, not only did they bring the rhythm, but they learned the Spanish language. What that did was that it brought beautiful Spanish lyrics to the music. And that is a vital part of the bomba, the lyrics of the bomba, the lyrics of the songs. So when we talk about bomba, a typical bomba ensemble will be, we don't use these drums, but this is what I have to demonstrate some of the rhythms. They use what is called barriles, and the barriles were made out of rum barrels, and the head of the drums were made out of goat skins. And that produces a really resonant sound. When you hear a group of bomba drums, you can really feel them. But today I am using a conga. On a typical bomba ensemble, there are two types of drums. There are buleadores, which are the ones that keep the rhythm going for the dancer and for the singer. And there could be one buleador and then one subidor or primo. The subidor or the primo marks the improvisations that the dancer is doing. So there's this really beautiful, exciting chemistry going on between the subidor, the man playing the subidor, and the dancer. Besides the dancer and the drums that I mentioned, the subidor and the buleador, there is cua. And Amy is going to be playing the kwa today on a couple of the rhythms. And the kwa is very similar to an instrument. It's very similar to an instrument that the Cubans have that they call the guagua or cata. Because like in the island, in Cuba also, the slaves came to work on the sugarcane fields. So they brought part of the culture also. And they, part of the culture, included this instrument that came really all the way from Africa. So the rumba for the Cubans is what the bomba is for the Puerto Ricans. They are like really national rhythms, national music. People are very proud of it. And we are very proud of our African heritage.